Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making bourbon brownies. I'm making this for Derby Day, and a lot of you have derby parties in my local area, and some of you throughout the United States or throughout the world possibly do. And I chose to make mint juleps and also to make bourbon brownies because those two things are very representative of Kentucky having bourbon in them. And the mint julep, of course, is the official drink of the Kentucky Derby. I do have Derby pie if you want to look at that in Betty's Kitchen, but I made that probably a couple of years ago, so I didn't want to repeat that process, but I think I named it Race Day Derby Pie or something like that. But you can find it if you search for a few of those words if you're interested. But today it's going to be bourbon brownies. So we start with making brownies, actually, and then later they get infused with bourbon, and then we have a couple of nice icings that go on top, and one of those has a bourbon flavor in it. So it's really appropriate for maybe a party or something like that where you want something that is a finger food, but it speaks of Kentucky. So here we go with a mixing bowl that has one well-beaten egg in it. Now to that, I'm gonna have some dry ingredients added, and I have a small bowl to put in 1 cup of sugar. That's just white granulated sugar. This is 2/3 of a cup of self-rising flour. So I'm gonna mix those together. Now you may use all-purpose flour if you prefer, and just for any single cup of all-purpose flour, you need to add 1 1/2 teaspoons of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Of course, this is just 2/3 of a cup, so you'd have to do the math on that to figure out how much you need of baking powder and salt to come up to where we are right now in our mixture. Now, in this little pot that I have to the right of me, you'll see I've already melted some items, and I put out here, just to show you what it is, I have 1 stick of butter, and this is upside down. This could be salted butter or unsalted butter. I've made it both ways. It doesn't make any difference, really. And then I have 2 squares of unsweetened baking chocolate. These are 1 ounce squares, so it could be just unsweetened chocolate as long as you get 2 ounces worth. But I wanted to get this melted on the stove so that it would have a chance to cool down a little bit and not scramble my eggs. Although we'll be careful in adding that when it's ready. But these were just to show you what went into that mixture. I will be adding 1 cup of chopped pecans and 1 teaspoon of vanilla as well. So let's go back over to our large bowl, and it would be better to get the liquids together, but remember this is still slightly warm. It's not hot, but it's warm, and we want to add some of it quickly and stir. And then add a little more and stir. And this is what keeps your eggs from trying to cook when you're adding something warm into it. And eventually you can just pour it all in and it will be fine. But when you see that it's smooth and not lumpy like pieces of scrambled egg, you know it's fine. Got a little more in here. It seems like every bit of that chocolate counts, because I really like chocolatey brownies. So I try to scrape all of that out and put that in my well-beaten egg. Okay, now we can put our dry mixture, which is the flour and sugar. We'll put that in. You can put it all in at once. And this is a stir recipe. So you can just stir this around. You don't have to have a mixer to beat air into it, because this is not the kind of dessert that is light and airy. It's more thick and fudgy and chewy. So you want to keep it like that by using something like a spatula or a spoon to stir this around. See how nice that looks? It almost looks like you could eat them right like this, almost as cooked brownies, but obviously we haven't cooked them. Now, I'm going to add my pecans. This seems like a lot, but these do call for 1 cup of chopped pecans and then our 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. And again, stir. And this takes a little bit of work because I'm doing it manually and there are a lot of nuts there. If you don't like the pecans, you may leave them out. Obviously, you see brownies all the time that have no nuts whatsoever, and that's not a critical component of our bourbon brownies. And I do want to emphasize that we're making our brownies first, and then we'll worry about putting the bourbon flavor into it. So the bourbon flavor doesn't come in yet. When you get this mixed about like this, that looks just about perfect. You can go to an 8-inch square pan. Now this could be a metal pan like I have here, or it could be a Pyrex dish. But 8 inches square is perfect for it, and you want to have it sprayed with cooking oil spray, and then you'll just put your batter. It's not a runny batter like cake mixes usually are. But you'll put this into your pan and then you'll spread it out as evenly as possible. Then this goes to a 350 degree oven and it will bake for about 25 minutes. But I really like my brownies taken out of the oven when they are done and cooked no longer than that, because they will have a tendency to be dry and crumbly if you overcook them. And the best trait of a brownie is for it to be chewy. You want to almost see it looking like this in the center, but of course not quite. You want it cooked all the way through, and it takes about 25 minutes. But I will tell you how long this actually takes. So I will see you back when our brownies are done. Our brownies have just come out of the oven and I did give them a toothpick test. That's what you want to do, is just use a clean toothpick and go to the deepest part. This is all level, so it doesn't really matter. I'll go to the center and put the toothpick in and it will come out clean. That's what you want. Even though these will be very chewy and moist inside, you do need them done. And an indication that they're not done is if this came out with a lot of the mixture on it, but it's clean. So we've gotten our brownies done and now we're turning to the liquor that goes in. This is whiskey and I'm using Maker's Mark whiskey. And I'll talk about how much and how to do it in just a second, but I want to tell you how synonymous Kentucky is with whiskey. Kentucky produces about 98% of all of the bourbon whiskey that is distilled and distributed around the world. Now, it might not be that high now. There may be competitors that have come in. It might be 96% or 92%. So if you look that up and found a different number, just know it's almost 100%. It's pretty high up there. So that's why we use bourbon whiskey in a lot of things we make. Our brownies need to have a way of getting the whiskey into it. Of course, I could just dribble it over the top and it would sink in, but the best thing to do is take a fork and just pierce. Just go all the way. It doesn't have to be any particular pattern because this is going to be covered up with 2 icings. And I can feel it being really moist there, and you know our toothpick came out clean, so we know it's done, but it is so moist. I think you'll love the texture of these. But I'm just about through making these little punch holes in it. And then I've chosen to use 3 ounces, and I may not use it all. My actual recipe calls for 4 ounces in this part and then some more in one of the icings. I feel like Rick and I will be keeping these and eating them ourselves instead of giving them away, because we don't like to give away alcoholic things, because I don't know, people maybe disapprove sometimes if they're taken to work or whatever. So we'll probably be keeping them ourselves, and we don't want it done in a heavy-handed way. But you might prefer more. So I'm just telling you, I'm using 3 ounces of bourbon whiskey, and I'm taking a pastry brush and just brushing it on. And this will take me a minute, so you probably don't want to watch all of this. So I'll go away and come back when I've got all of this infused into our brownies. I have finished putting the bourbon into the brownies, and you can see I can touch this. So this is warm, but it's very warm. And what I'm going to do is to make an icing that is bourbon flavored, and that will go on the top of this. I don't want the icing melting down into it, so I'm going to cool this first. I'm not going to chill it or anything. I'm just going to wait until it naturally cools. And then there will be a second icing on top of the first icing. So we have a little more to do, but the thing to do right now is just wait until this cools down. Here are cooled brownies that have been infused with bourbon, and I can feel at the bottom, and there might be the slightest amount of warmth, but basically these have cooled off, and that's what we need in order to put our buttercream frosting on top. It's bourbon buttercream frosting, and I put it in a previous upload. So you'll need to look at that in order to get the frosting that you need as the next layer. But I'll tell you, it's just 1 stick of softened butter, 2 cups of confectioner sugar, and 1 to 2 ounces of bourbon whiskey. And just beat it all together, and what you get is something like this. But if you need to look up the instructions, it will be under Betty's bourbon buttercream frosting. Now we just spoon it out and put it on top here, and it should spread very easily. So here's what our brownies look like after you spread that first layer of icing on. And you don't have to decorate it like that, but if you want to stop at this point, then it's nice to put a few peaks in it, and then you can just cut it into squares. You can actually chill it first, and I would suggest that you do that so that the icing cooperates better. Since we're going to put another icing on top, we really need to chill that. So that's going into the refrigerator. And I'm going to prepare the second icing, which is really just a glaze, a chocolate glaze that goes on top. But I will have to cool it down, so I might as well start right now. I have 1 cup of semi-sweet chocolate chips, and I have 2 tablespoons of butter. It is softened, but that's not important because this is going to the stove. What I have to do here is go over to the stove and melt this. So it's not complicated at all. Melt it and then let it cool down. And if I have a refrigerated pan of brownies, then I will be able to pour this over the top or spread it over the top. Even if I chill it a little bit, it will have more body, and I'll be able to get more mileage out of the spreading aspect. We're ready to put our second frosting on our bourbon brownies. You know, it's just a glaze, sort of. It's chocolate and butter, and that's all. And it's still a little bit warm, but in order for it to be a little bit liquid, you don't want it to cool off completely. And that creates a little bit of a problem with the other frosting, because if this is not set, then you're going to have the two mixing together. So what I did was move this from the refrigerator to the freezer for a few minutes. So the top is nice and smoothed out, and also it's nice and cold. So I'm going to spread this, but I'm going to have to probably dot it a little bit, maybe make long strings of it, and then sort of connect the dots. I'm just finishing up with the topping here, the chocolate topping, and you can make some kind of design in this. And actually, I sort of finished my design, and as it sits here over that icy layer, it wasn't all that cold, but it was from the freezer, it's setting up quite a lot. What you should do at this point, Your brownies are finished. Cover them with plastic wrap and put them in the refrigerator until you're ready to serve them. We have our bourbon brownies complete and ready to serve. I did put them in the refrigerator and let them sit for a couple of hours because in cutting the first couple of pieces, I did find that it was a little runny on top, and that affected the looks a little bit, so it was worth waiting a while. And what I do is just cut across the center and then across the center, and you have four equal sections. From there, you can decide if you want a long bar piece like that, that's sort of a double brownie, or if you cut across like this, then you're going to have the smaller size brownies. And generally, those are easier to remove. I just have a knife right here to pry that up with. But it's really easy to work with once you refrigerate it. And the brownie does not stick to the bottom because we sprayed the bottom there. And that's what it looks like. So here is our bourbon brownie that we're going to use to celebrate Derby Day here in Kentucky. And I hope you're able to use it too. I'm going to take a taste of our bourbon brownie, and it's been chilled, so it's going to be a little bit harder than it might be if it were sitting at room temperature. And normally you would probably serve it after it is set out for a little bit at room temperature. But I'm going to go down through here and get some of all layers. See how pretty it is? I think you'll really enjoy serving it with a hot drink like coffee, or in my case I have iced tea with some mint in it just to celebrate the day. And here we go with the bite. It's phenomenal. And for me, it's just the right amount of bourbon. You can taste the bourbon in that buttercream frosting, and you can taste it a little bit in the brownie. So if you want to increase it, I would be more of the mind of increasing it in the brownie than in the buttercream frosting. But it's just simply delicious, and you could add more bourbon if you like it really stiff, but this is perfect for me. I hope you enjoy it.